Hey everybody, it's Dave. We're here visiting one of my advertisers on pyrotalk.com that sells fireworks. It's Kneppys Fireworks. Now they're located in Pennsylvania. Now if you want to look, we're like way out in the country here, so you know. So we got a fireworks store out in the middle of the country here in Pennsylvania. Now when you look on your GPS, you're going to look for the address 204 LIMB Road, and the town is Morris, M-O-R-R-I-S-D-A-L-E, Mossisdale, PA for Pennsylvania. I mean, we're so far out, it's really not even on the GPS the address that they have listed, but we kind of cross-referenced it. And you can see some of the brands that she sells here, Cannon, World Class, Brothers. She kind of picks the best of the brands. More world class here, and a different variety of a lot of things. Now what makes this store kind of different is the laws in Pennsylvania only allow you to buy ground-based fountain items unless you specifically have a permit. Now if you come from out of state here, then you're kind of exempt from all those rules, and you just sign a paper and then take your product out of the state of Pennsylvania. So we're gonna go in and see Joyce, who owns Kneppys Fireworks. I'll kind of have this listed in the description of the video for some more reference. Let's go see how it's going. Okay, before we go in, we're going to take a little look at the outside here before we go in. Now, if you look over here, the store is actually bigger than what it appears because she has all of her stock in magazines right next to the store here. Now, she sells just one floor product, so that magazine is going to be sufficient for her needs. If you listen real close, you might even hear a cow over there. So we're kind of out in farm country. So fireworks make their way all over. Hey, let's go ahead and take a look. Here's the owner, Joyce Kneppys. Joyce Kneppy, Kneppys Fireworks here. If you want to know how to spell it, show them the shirt, Joyce.
K. Kneppys with a K. The K is silent.
All right. Thank you for sticking with my website.
Sure. And thank you for coming over, Dave. Really appreciate you coming over.
Okay. Well, we want to take a little look around. I know that you kind of sell a little bit of brands of a lot of different things. There's a certain section of the store that's for a Pennsylvania customer. Now, a Pennsylvania customer is welcome to purchase anything in the store if they have a local permit from their local township.
That is correct, yes.
Yeah. Now, just explain that for someone in Pennsylvania. How does that work?
Our website has a downloadable application forms. That's exactly what it is, just a form.
Yeah.
You take it to your local township supervisor, borough manager, or whatever, and most of the boroughs and townships have rules and regulations governing permit issuing, mm-hmm. and the state does too. They basically follow the state and maybe put in a couple of their own little things that they want, and hopefully you find their graces and they'll do you a permit. If you don't, then you're can have the what's called in our state the Pennsylvania legal or safe and sane items.
Okay. Now, someone from out of state, I know we're close to New York State or other states too. If someone comes from out of state, they sign a form that they're taking them back to their state and follow the rules in their
own
state.
Yes, our laws changed back in November 2004, mm-hmm. and it clarified some gray areas that the older laws had, and basically what it said that they had to identify themselves as being from a different state, and we personally have a form. Different companies do it differently, but we have a form from the field out. We take their driver's license number, the license plate, and we keep it on file for our Department of Agriculture to inspect once a year when they come for inspection.
Okay.
Like I said, different companies does it differently. That's how we do it here.
Okay. So no matter where you live, you're welcome here.
Yes, you are.
Okay. Let's just glance through the Pennsylvania section because, you know, we usually start with, like, what? Fountains and things like that.
Fountains and sparklers, of course. No, that's not the Pennsylvania section, Dave.
Okay. Here it is over here.
Yes,
right?
Over here it is. Okay. Here, we have some fountains here. As you can see, we're kind of a small store, so we have these kind of mixed up. Some bigger fountains.
Oh, you carry Glorious,
Big
brand.
Glorious, yeah. Biggs.
Mm-hmm. Cannon.
Brothers.
Mm-hmm.
We carry a large variety of different brands, world class.
Some of these kind of put on a show by themselves, don't they? I mean, they 500 grams, some of them, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, for example, like the super fountain here from the brothers here, drew a nice 500 gram fountain, but it has a fan effect to it, so you get like a grand finale show with it.
Yeah. You know, I always wanted to do just like a, well, it's probably all states, but because I live in Pennsylvania, a Pennsylvania legal show. Like,
right.
Connect some of these things on a firing system and just do a nice little quiet show in my backyard. I know a lot of them, instead of like firecrackers, they substitute a crackling effect or
something.
Yeah,
like we're not crackle effects and whistles, and a lot of stuff has crackles and whistles. Some rather large and very loud crackles. Like, for example, what you have your hands on, the Silver Cracking Dragon Cone, has a real nice loud crackle effect.
Yeah, these are nice fountains. Okay, so over here, these are Roman candles.
Now, these are Roman candles, of course.
Permit or out of state?
Permit or out of state, yes, sir.
Now, what brands do we have here?
Well, that particular brand there is Canon brand stuff. And again, we carry all brands on that. We have some world-class brand candles. We have some Biggs candles, and various different kinds.
I know that there's been times through the years I'll take quite a, you know, some of these and angle them and do different effects if you want to get fancy with them. But you should never hold it in your hand.
Absolutely not. Read the directions on the label. And most it says, do not hold in hand. So follow the directions. You'll be okay.
Oh, this is a monster one here. Yeah. Nice big one. I know years ago, many years back, they used to have 40, 50 shot candles. And I think now they kind of have a limit on how many candles. I've seen them as high as 20 shot.
Roman candles are kind of weird like that. You have some 8-shot candles, those are large 8-shot candles, that's only 8-shot. However, down, we're having some rocket problems
here. You got too much stock, huh?
I guess so. Have to come in later and thin it down here for me, Dave.
All right, we'll leave it here.
Okay, that's okay. Like, for example, here, these are like over 100-shot Roman candles and that. I don't know how they squeeze all those shots into candles.
Yeah.
I guess
it's more than one problem,
there's
yeah.
a long skinny tube, they said, I guess, inside it. Mm-hmm. Shoots out a bunch of little pearl shots and that.
Yeah. Okay, bottle rockets, always a favorite.
Traditional bottle rockets, yes.
Okay, let's take a look over here. Now, you know what, just from knowing some of the ones I know this is a Good Brothers cape. This Wild West, I shot a few of these.
That's a nice all-around cape. It's an older cape, it's an older style, but it's one of my favorites. That's why we keep it in stock all the time.
A lot of good brands. Mega Banger is a good brand. World Class, of course, is a good one. And, the parachutes. Yeah, Parachute Battalion.
Parachute Battalion.
Kids always love these.
Kids love that. They like to go fetch those up whenever they go, come floating down. That's one of their big things.
Mm-hmm. Let's take a look over here. Scuba diver.
Yeah, we have some, we ran out of room. This used to be my fountain section also, but ran out of room here for some of the 500-gram cakes. The 500-gram cakes are getting more popular nowadays.
Yeah.
They put off a very nice show for not that bad of a price.
Yeah, look, this is a world-class cake. It's like pretty massive for sure. Yeah, this is the thing now. People want little shows, you know.
Right.
Light it and the whole thing. Just everybody sits back and enjoys it. Oh, okay. There's assortments you carry?
We carry assortments. We only have one assortment room right now. Later on here, we actually have assortments coming here sometime this next week from a container from Biggs that will have some other assortments that's on that as well.
Mm-hmm. This is when you can't make your mind up, where your kids are like, hey, look, just get the assortment, okay? This is what you're telling them.
Exactly.
Right, just get the assortment and throw it in the car. Okay, another world-class cake. So what you do is you, like this, for example, this is running low. You have more. You just
I have more.
It
yes,
you
I have
to
stock it as we need it here. And then, like I said, we have some stuff coming. It's just not here yet. That's why you see the empty holes.
We got a little extra back here. Now it looks like with the, you know, I always like recommend artillery shells for people. I recommend you get a rack if you want to shoot more than one, you know, together. But you have some of the better brands of artillery shells.
We try to keep what I like to call the best of the best, and like the very popular items that sell and everything like that. Including the pro shells, yes.
Those are always good sellers.
Always very good, yes.
Here's another one that's been popular through the years.
Smoke and Mirrors is always a nice one from Brothers.
Brothers. I see you have some Kellner's product here.
I have some,
this is one of my recommended buys.
Yes.
From Bobby, right here.
That's a very nice shell.
If you can't drive all the way to Bobby Kellner's, you could come to Kneppy's and pick it up.
There you go.
Yeah, that's a good one. And you get a tube, a mortar, everything with it. Yeah, you got some of the better ones here. Oh, let's see. These are ball shells. Matrix Pyra. I actually have an order in for a case of these I'm buying when I go to the Cracker Jacks. This is a good one. For sure.
It's always a good solid performer every year.
Yeah. Single shot items.
Yeah, we carry some. We just started doing that here. We've had them off and on, but started dealing with bigs, and I like their single shot tubes there, so we started handling those.
Mm-hmm. These are, I guess, for your budget.
It was a nice budget type ball shell, yes.
Yeah, that's a counter item. World class. Yeah, we're looking good. Here's a nice 500 gram selection right
yeah,
here.
Yeah, these are all 500 gram cakes here.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. They all look good. Okay, so you come to Kneppy's. Little selection, depending on where you live. You know, look that up according to the address I gave you. She has a demo tonight of some of these products we're going to take a look at. And I think there's even like a little show tonight. After the demo, where they're going to take product that she's selling, am I correct, and try to put it into a little...
We're going to take product that we're selling, and we invited the guys from the Western New York Pyrotechnics Association,
yeah.
And which I'm a member of, and they've got together, and they do an excellent job of putting on a nice little 5 to 7 minute pyro musical.
I know Jay always talks highly of you.
Yes.
From that club. So we're going to check that out. I just wanted you to get a look at the store. Look it up on a GPS. You're looking to buy some product. If you're in the surrounding area, New York, permitted in Pennsylvania, out of state, that sort of thing, keep her in mind. Okay, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Okay, here we are down at Joyce's demo. This is where the pyro musical will be tonight later on to write. Just to give you an idea, they kind of rented a piece of property here off of the fire department. Then you get a local permit. Then they could do a demo of their product. That's probably going to be just like any other demo. It's going to start with the little stuff. You can see looks like little strobe pots here. And I think they're going to do it all electronically. I can see yellow wire right here. Although if they are, they got a lot of wiring up to do. Oh no, they got a torch here. Start with some of the fountains. They have numbered. Oh, here's a cool one. Looks like a computer. It's a world class one. That's great, great, great strategy how to sell one. How to sell something. See, when you sell consumer fireworks, it really is all about the labels sometimes, you know? How creative you can be. Just from the looks of that computer, it'll be a big seller for them. Yeah, she has TNT fireworks here, Liberty. She kind of sells a little bit of a lot of stuff. Maybe this is, this is a Sky Lantern. They'll set off tonight. Okay, here's a 500 gram. Okay, and we'll work down this way. see these guys are setting up here. Then the demo kind of starts this way. See, she has racks. Let's see how they numbered this thing. Looks like somebody's been shooting here already. Oh, this is where they probably had their open shoot last night that I couldn't make it to. Candles. See, that one that's multi-shot is basically just, it's a big on the outside, but there's a bunch of straight candles inside. Let's see what this one is.
Rock on?
Yeah.
This, what was it, 12.1 on it? No.
See with this one. Nice little rack. Fountains. These are demo of the artillery shelves. There's an idea. A little gum band in there. Kind of line your fuses up. Number these things somehow to reference it, I'm sure. Yeah, she has quite a few artillery shells for sale. Okay, let's start up the other end. See, this is all products she pulled right off of the shelf. Tape down. There's a brand I haven't heard before. Coconut song. That's funny. So it's kind of clinical, so to speak. You know, you just kind of set it up and keep hearing about this cake, Asian Sensations. Ooh, this is a good one. Attitude adjustment. That's kind of it. It's a 1.4 demo and do one product at a time. Let me do a little skim of this little musical they're going to do tonight. This will give you an idea how they're kind of setting things up here. This is a mix of product that Joy sells and some of their own product mixed in. You can see here's a Fire One module. And this must be, I'm not familiar with this one. This is a Fire One, kind of a rail system all jammed in there. And if you look, you'll see a black wire comes out of the module. This is the two-wire system. If you can see, there's two little electrical ports there. And you just assign a number to it and set your product up. You see all the wires. Here, we'll look down this way too. You see what they've done is they've taken apart some of the I don't know which product it is, but you could kind of see where they ripped off a tube. This is the kind of the true way to do a 1.4 consumer fireworks pyro musical, where you kind of rip a cake apart and assign a number to each mortar and then just kind of go from there. That's interesting, an angled rack. It's very, very time consuming, yes, doing it this way. That's kind of how they kind of did each one. Here's one down here we could look at. This is all consumer product. It's one of my cakes in there. I like Matrix Pyro. You can see, let's see how they kind of, can't really see where the electric match is going in. They may have just stuck it right in the cake for a little faster effect. Yeah, it's probably like kind of jammed in there. This is probably finale. Yeah, hopefully salutes. Nice little salute chain. That's just their kind of basic setup.
We're still at Kneppy's demo. You can see Joe is in charge of the music tonight and the announcement. He has a list he's going to run down. Where's your microphone?
Did my dog come up all right?
He already gave me one of those Italian cupcakes. I couldn't wait. I had to eat it. You gave me more of those cupcakes?
Oh, yeah. A lot of cupcakes.
Yeah. So what he'll do tonight, he'll read this, just shoot it, and then we'll just sit back and watch it. I mean, it's a small demo, but it's just as enjoyable. There's a lot of guys here from the state of New York. Their pyrotechnics group's here today. You can see they have I'll show you in a minute, they got a Fire One set up. They're going to do about a 6.5 minute pyro musical at the end of the demo. So that's something for us to look forward to.
Okay, here's the demo list tonight.
Is there a whole lot in there?
Check the master cable.
I think that computer one's just so ingenious. Good, so it's very well thought out for a fountain item. You can see all the brands are here. And there's 2 pages.
Don't give me an excuse, you're working either.
So there is quite a bit here to shoot tonight. And this pyro musical tonight over here, the boys from New York are going to shoot. It's about 6 minutes, 6.5 minutes.
It's supposed to be clean.
So they're going through their continuity checks now. Okay, you can see they have the Fire One light set up. Now you actually can run this without a computer, and you can run it with a computer. So you take a wire here, and it kind of runs, what the heck do they call those ports? It's actually an older style port. But if you look, there's a USB drive. He probably has the program in that. And he could communicate, and he could check continuity right from his laptop. Then he communicates to somebody out there. My guess is this is the backup. In case this one doesn't work, they always have another one. I know when we did some of the larger shows, when I was with Zambelli, you always have a backup.
Okay, welcome ladies and gentlemen to our 8th annual Kneppy's Fireworks products demonstration. I just do want to real quick check here with the fire technician, see if the all systems are go. They're giving me the go sign, so we're going to go. Again, welcome to our show here this evening, and we have a lot of nice stuff here for you, some nice fireworks. We're going to start it off with one of our local gentlemen who also works for Kneppys Fireworks, Mr. Mike Smeal, who's going to sing the national anthem. When you're ready, Mike.
And the rockets red still the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Hey,
Play ball.
Balloons, but we have, and these are available at Kneppys Fireworks. We have the flag design plus the different colors, and mixture of colors that we have, plus the all white.
What's it like that other one?
That's slowing down a little bit. Oh boy. The next one, number 17, big balls, three pieces from Big. Very nice, very nice.
You don't know what the shells can do. Number 34, pro shells. They are a canister shell. Pro shells from Biggs, number 34.
This sounds great. Oh, yeah.
38, Aquarian. It's a 12-shot cake from AFW Bria.
This used to be really a good cake. Let's see what it sounds like. Still does sound good. Oh yeah. That's a good one.
Okay, that was on the 38 Aquarian. Sharp Shooter. 12 shot from Biggs. Number 91, Sharp Shooter from Biggs. That is nice. Okay, here. Now we have two different colors of tickets here. I forget what the colors are. Hold on, they gotta tell me.
Call somebody up there.
We need some. We have one of the kids in the audience come up. We got a kid. One. Okay, zero, zero,
okay,
nine.
Here's,
there's one here.
One of their promos here.
Two of them.
For their fireworks. Gives the kids, all the kids get a chance to win something. It's kind of cool.
Frisbee.
It's a nice little promo item. See the guys here getting their guys from New York here. Western New York Pyrotechnics Association are getting their little 6-minute show ready on the Fire One system.
Okay, we're going to draw two more. Okay, I have one here in my lap. I don't think anybody came just yet. 004. Okay, they say anytime, so. Western New York Pyrotechnics Association presents the 8th annual Kneppys Fireworks Pyro Musical. Thank you. Thank you.